Hi guys, I'm back. Was gonna continue and start picking out the ephemera and see where we're at because it's starting to get thick. This file folder added, you know, a good chunk right there. But anyway, I thought, well, we start picking out ephemera and seeing what we want where, then that will help kind of determine what else is needed, at least in my mind. So here's all the ephemera pieces that I've been making in the little ephemera box. I just love it. So I think we should give it a shot. This pull out with the removable Rolodex cards. I went ahead and stamped on that. So I did do some stamping on things that I knew needed to be writing space. All right, what do I got going on here? Let me slide that one down so I can pop that one back in there. There. And then those just slide. However you want them. And then they hide back in their little house right here. I just love how this front has turned out, with all the little flips and flops. And I did add this really pretty feather. I liked it. I thought it tied it all in. Pockets and tucks and pocket. So I'm thinking if we just start here and then kind of flip back and forth, might be able to be easier. But now of course that caught my eye because of the colors. It's on the back of this side. Ooh, that could be a good place. This is the little journaling tablet with removable that we made. And that could slide right over. Like that. Do we like that, or is that too greeny? Okay. Let's just, maybe I shouldn't have just started diving in like that. Let me get back to the beginning. That's funny. I got excited there for a minute. Okay. So I kind of had an idea with the little envelopes too that we made going Oop. I forgot about that one. Going maybe here because of the color choices. And then that's just an envelope, so we could tag that on there. I really like that. What do you guys think? There's that one, and then there's the one with the red. I'm thinking the red. And I'm just gonna drape that over and leave that clip on there. So if that one went there, then we could do the matching on this one. Put that one, yep. And then slide that one over. Okay, so we might have to move that one because this one actually has a pocket and a tuck. I don't know if I'm, that might be good in the middle. And then line stamp here for journaling. Okay, let's leave that one. I think the center, I love how the center turned out. I ended up changing this a little bit from the last video because this hanky is pretty fragile once you put the glue on there. It was, and I wasn't sure if it was going to be sturdy enough in there. So what I ended up doing is just like a hidden spine again, I took this muslin and then I sewed the fabric right to the muslin and then glued the muslin into the center of the book. And I'm really pleased with how that turned out. I feel much better, much more confident that that's going to hold. And then I like the layout of the laces better too. So I'm glad I took that out and redid it. So if it looks a little different from the last video, that's why. Because it is. Okay. So we go from there to this. And what do we have on this page? So this one I just added. Oh, I did snip this little leftover. This, it was big and hangy. And then I added it onto this pocket right here, and I thought that kind of ties it in nicely. So maybe we just start pulling out some of our ephemera. What color? Kind of green. Maybe we'll pull the green across. Let's see what that looks like. What do we think about that? And the clock shows. Might could add a little script stamp or something here. And then, of course, I'm going to line stamp back there. So when I do the final flip through, it'll be even a little bit more different. Because I'm going to stamp. But right now, I just want to see where I'm at as far as thickness goes. And some of these are pretty... Oh yeah, the double-sided... That's really cute. That would have looked cool there. With the little tag in the file folder. But what happens if I clip it on here? And then this already has a pocket and pocket and pocket and another pocket. Yeah, that tab's going to be in the way. Okay, well, we'll find another spot for it. And he is going to be on the back side, so we want to do one that doesn't have lace. If we can find that. So maybe him there. And then this one would be made for this side. Let's try him here. That's kind of cute, huh? Just a little lonely little butterfly right there. Cluster. And then when we turn him, might need to add a little topper right there. I actually have some script stamped muslin. What do you... I think I'm going to do that. I'm going to cut this right quick. Where are my scissors? Might get a good chunk of this done and be able to share it with you guys. I think. I like that. Gray there. We don't like that. I think. Let's just do it. Let's just put it on there. Okay, so now I could either glue it, tie it, or what if I stapled it? Let me turn this. Hopefully I can stay in camera so you guys can see. Because then I can always come back and change the color of this. Staple if I need to. And it goes with our grungy theme. I like that. Okay. And I'm still not sure about these tabs. I may remove them. Okay, so if he's there, I love that. Then let's go. What side is it? One more. Trying to look at the signature to see if that, for some reason, I'm thinking it's this one. But it can't be that one if this is the back. Can I? What do I get going on? No. I'm actually farther back than I thought I was. It's right there. So if we did him here. Isn't he cute? And then here. Okay, so do we have this one? That would look good there. And then that's the back side with this kind of the reds and black. Let's put him on here. And then there's also a pocket back here for journaling notes or whatever. Blacks and reds, okay. And there's that one. There's this one. This one's pretty full. We don't want to put anything else in here or in there. And then we have a pocket. And a pocket. That one kind of ties together the colors. What do you guys think? You like that one? Let's see if we can poke that little head in there. I'll move those to the top. I try to keep my bulk spaced out so that the book closes evenly. So if that one's there. Then the other page is right here. And we have a pocket. Oh, I wonder. I just gessoed this one, so I didn't even. Let's see. What about that? Where's my pockets? There's pocket up top, pocket behind, and pocket here. And if we stick that down, those colors pull. Then I also have this one. And this one has side pocket, and then a pocket there. And if we'd attach that like so. I say let's do this one. Where's the glue? Oop. Okay, and I don't think it needs a back behind pocket because, well, might as well. I have it. Let's just use it. Doesn't mean it's got to be filled. Right? But it's there on a just in case. All right. And I tried to go just the side of the stitching so that you can still see the stitching. Give that a good push. Okay, that'll look good once that dries. So then if we have the other matcher, where would we put it? Over here. Who's got pockets? And that one already has a pocket that goes with that. But these here are pretty plain. So, let's see. This could be our journaling page. We got room right here. That pocket goes. Pocket. So again, I don't like that on the inside. But if we did it here, then the pocket, the tags could come out. And then up, and then that adds color here. So let's glue this one down. That's my first time ever picking out ephemera with you guys, so. And go ahead and put some glue right there and help hold that down. So a new experience for me here. Okay. I'm just going to really give that a good push, help hold that. Okay. Oh. And we have, I wonder if I'm going to have room for this one. Remember when we created that one? This one is really cool with the clock inside and the butterfly. Let's see. Maybe. Maybe we want to move this. Let's check this out for a minute. Oh, I think that. Let's see. Maybe we want to come off the bottom on a sturdy page. What would we be covering up? So if I put this here, we'd be kind of covering up some of that. And that might be too thick for the center. But let me see. No, we still got room. What do you guys think? Should we add that there? It'll overhang a hair. But then all of this is overhanging too, so I don't think that that would matter. Feel that there, but I think it would be okay. The only thing I'm worried about is not being able to glue this right here clear to the end. So what if we glued it there? Adds a little bit, but I think it would be okay. What do you guys think? And we could do her there. And she's got a flower on. Well, now we got that trim right there. And I think it would raise the bulk up above that. What else do we have? He's kind of thick. And we have our little slider here. So we could actually put that in the middle and then slide it, and there would be a hidden envelope. I have a video on this if you guys have needed to know how to make a cute little slider. Thinking those, probably those colors don't go. Maybe it'll go with one of these. Where did we put? Okay, there's center. Where did we put the other little? Oh, here. So there's green, and then this is green with the blue, and then green and the blue, and then green. So that would pull it nicely together. And if we glue it right there, then this could be all journaling, or we could glue it here. What's on this side, though? We could glue it on this side. And then this could be all journaling line stamped. And then a pocket, and then pockets and journaling. Okay, let's do it. Okay, so the big thing with the sliders is we want to make sure that we don't glue the slide. So I'm just going to glue it about here, which should act as its stop. And then the same here. which should also, so it should stop at the top and the bottom. Put it on there. These are so fun to make, and I like how they are like little hidden. So slide, that'll pop. Try not to slide too much until that glue dries. Okay. We'll leave that alone for right now. That's cute. I like it. Okay. And then, let's see. Need something in here, but not one. These guys are clips. This guy's not, but this is kind of feminine. Do we have a... feminine looking... kind of wedding-y. Then we have that one. And I'll hold off on those ones. Then what, black? Here's some black and white. And then her. Decisions, decisions. Okay, wait. And this one I just put in there for a see-through, so I'm thinking I'm gonna, and it's a journaling tag, but I better put the cap on my glue. Jeez. But I'm thinking a postcard would be really cool in there. Because this is a postcard in the back with the script. So we'll see. I might have to make one of those. And then my idea is journaling here and journaling here. This is recycled paper, and it is, I just love the feel of it. It is so nice. And then here's grid paper for journaling, and then journaling. Okay, so now we're here. This is gonna need something in the, and I think those colors will match. What? There. I think that looks cute. Little flip, and then maybe if I line stamped that way. And then I'm going to need little tags for in here. That might be a hair too big. So what if we dig in the stash? I just have some lines stamped. This one, where did that come? Oh, that came out of here. Little tag. What if we do that? The colors are right. And it's just a little note. And then a little birdie. Isn't he cute? with a little tag tucked into this pocket. And he's peeking out. Yeah, I think we should put that there. And then there's another pocket here, so whoever gets this could put another in there if they wanted to. Or if we have a smaller one, one with a little typewriter. Do we got one on the other side? No, they're all on the right. Oh wait, here's one on the left. That kind of ties it together. What do you guys think? Okay. And then we have blues. So I have the shaker card. Kind of not really a... Oh yeah, it's a shaker. It's got little... But the colors are right. And then there's that little funny bird again. And it's sewed on a tag. So... I shook those up. So maybe distress that and then you can go in there. Right quick, we'll see what this looks like. Wasn't planning on using the little birds, but they are in my stash. And it's kind of cool to be able to use up your stash a little bit. I think this would be like part, is this part 8? So we're moving along a lot better than what I was thinking. And I could add a cute little topper to that. I'll have to see. Those might be a little... something a little different maybe the next time we craft together. When I go line stamping and stuff, I might be able to dig out some trim to match the trim and maybe pull the colors. But for now we'll poke him in there. And this, I love this. I love how this one turned out. Okay, and then we'll need something in here. Or do we? Because here's this pocket. I'm afraid I'm not going to be able to use that one. But this might be the perfect place for this one. Because it's removable. It'll add cute... pop a color, the greens and the browns, so that will pull over with some burgundy. And then that looks pretty vintagey. Maybe I'll end up put a pocket right here with the clip. Okay. So I'm thinking, that's good, Carrie, that's good. I'm thinking that I probably, now I'm at the point where I just need to do some line stamping and because this is getting pretty thick. So, the attach. Maybe I'll end up swapping those two. And then this one. And I really like the way that this one clustered. So, this one can be an add-on, like on a journaling page, I think. Yeah, too big. Oh, that might be a bummer. Oh well, let's save it for later if we can't use it. Okay, so I think I'm gonna call that good for now. If you guys have any suggestions, please let me know if you've seen something go somewhere and it looked like I should have put it there. But I think I'll go ahead and get off and start doing some line stamping and stuff because I don't think anybody wants to watch me line stamp. And then kind of put another one eye over it. Figure out what to put in those couple little tuck spots. And then we'll be ready to do the cover and poke some pieces of ephemeris in the pockets and stuff. So, all right, we'll stay tuned and we'll see. Once you start stamping, it kind of takes its own little life on. Looks really a lot different. So that'll be the next process. So stay tuned and I will see you soon. Goodbye.